I will be playing the role of Seth. Welcome to the production of Mr. Colin Coleman, of the production of Mariah Marten, or The Murder in the Red Barn.
I have worked for, and I'm very tired.
Oh, poor soul.
Sit you down here, and I will go and fetch something for you.
Oh, bless you, pretty one. My sister was kind and gentle that day. Her life it was happy, with none to dismay. Till Cawdor did meet her, oh, a sad day to prove. For she listened while he spoke his false words of love. He ruined her life and then cast her aside. Oh, lonely she fell and her heart did burn. Came to her side when her life it had fled, laying her to rest in her last deadly bed. Ah, here I am again in the village of Posted, where my poor young sister died of a broken heart. Betrayed and discarded by a villain.
Ooh.
And a seducer. But I have vowed vengeance against him. And if this girl is heart-free, then I shall use her as my weapon.
No!
And through her, we'll send that villain to the scaffold. Shut up. But hush, she comes.
I have some bread and cheese for you to take with you.
Oh, your heart is as kind as your face is pretty, my dear. What can I do to repay you?
Oh, nothing. I give it to you freely.
But Sarah Hearn does not take something for nothing. I am poor, but I am proud. Give me your hand.
My hand?
Your hand.
But why?
So that I may read your future for you.
My future?
Your future.
No.
Come, lady. Pretty lady. Come here, sit by my side.
I am afraid.
Don't be afraid. I don't bite. Round around the garden like a I jest. But this is a most lucky hand.
Lucky?
Lucky. I see. Reaches.
That's a freckle.
One moment. Ah, yes. I see love. I see adoration, and I see riches!
Riches?
Riches!
Oh no, you're mistaken.
No, riches, not reaches, reaches, reaches!
I know!
All right. Soon, very soon, you will meet a rich and handsome gentleman.
It's all I ever hoped for.
No!
And will he fall in love with me?
Oh, indeed he will.
No.
Shut up, I curse you all.
And marry me?
Oh, my darling, and he will marry you. Did I not say these were the very lucky hand?
Oh, I'm so happy. Do you speak me truth?
Oh, I speak you truth, my dear.
Boo.
You just don't shut up. So if you keep your heart free for him, I must be on my way.
Goodbye, and thank you.
Bless you, pretty one. Shut up. Oh, yes! And remember what the gypsy said!
Melania, whatever's the matter? You look all bemused.
she?
She made me very happy.
These young people, they were coming in for tea.
Oh, are they coming out? Are you right, so? Yeah. Oh, I called you in too. I want to feed you up before I wed thee. Hey, this cottage is a bit small.
It's a bit cheeky.
Maria, what is it? What that gypsy say to you?
Nothing I can tell you, Jemmy.
But Maria, you must. It's changed you somehow.
No, Jemmy, no.
But Maria...
Oh, leave me alone, Jemmy. I'm going that way.
No.
Leave me
alone. Maria. Oh. What's happened since I last left her? She's changed. She never used me thus before. No vows and not exchanged. I've loved her for many a day, but I'll still persevere with constant hearts and tender love. I'll hope to win my dear.
My blood, and I am determined I will have her.
But
No!
I saw her in the orchard as I came to the cottage. Shall I go there and meet her? Accidentally?
No!
No!
No! No! No! Happy chance. Here she comes. Why so hasty, pretty maiden?
Oh, sir.
Another second and you would have ran into my arms.
I do beg. All right. Do beg your pardon, sir. I wasn't looking. I was running away from Jemmy Hogan.
And who is this Jimmy Hogan?
Jemmy
Hogan. That you should run away from him.
He wants to be my sweetheart, sir.
Oh, does he now? Yeah. I must admit, Jimmy Hogan has...
Jemmy
Hogan has a good taste.
Oh, sir, you mustn't flatter me.
I speak the truth. In fact, I'd willingly be Jimmy Hogan's...
Jemmy!
I'd willingly be Jimmy Hogan's rival.
Hey!
You, sir? Oh, no, you jest.
I myself, sweet Mariah. I've seen you often, though perhaps you've not seen me.
Yes, I have, sir.
And wished as many times that I would speak to you and tell you of my love.
Your love?
My love.
Yeah. Your love?
My love.
Do you mean your love for me?
My love for you. May I, dare I, hope that you return my passion? Speak, dear Mariah, and tell me that I do not love in vain.
Oh, but sir, I am
far beneath you.
What would you want with me, a simple poor man's daughter?
I wish...
A poor man's daughter.
I wish for your heart and hand. I wish to marry you.
Remember what the gypsy said.
Stop it.
All right. Go on.
Hand down, Arthur.
You know what? I tell you, you tried to put a show on and all this happened.
I wish to marry you.
To marry me?
Will you become my wife?
Oh, it would be all I never longed for. Oh, what happiness. Will you take me away from this place?
No!
Perhaps to London? No.
Anywhere your heart desires, only say yes to me.
Oh, yes, dear William, yes!
No!
You come back here, there are dishes to be done, and you are not going out before the dishes are done!
Mother, I'm receiving a marriage proposal out here.
Remember what the gypsy said.
Yes, dear William, yes.
Oh, sweet Mariah.
When shall we tell my friends? Shall we tell them now?
No, not yet.
But what if you wish to marry me?
We must delay our marriage. My mother will be against it.
And we must part.
No! We shall not part. I will find a place for you to live, and then, in a month or two, I will come and visit you, and then I will produce you as my bride.
Oh, my love, my dearest.
I have her now.
Oh, no.
Now I must go. My mother must not see us together.
When will I hear from you?
In a month or two, I promise. Farewell.
To think that I am loved by such a splendid gentleman.
He's a slime ball.
It's all happening as the gypsy said. Nothing can tear me from William Corder!
sorry for doing kneeling down like a pair of peasants.
You call this theatrical?
Ooh,
yeah.
This is theatrical.
No, it's not.
Listen, get back to the camp.
But sir!
Do as I say. Was torn out by this villain. I have no words. Whose gentle heart was from this villain torn? Revenge is near. He'll rule the day that he who's eating you is gone. For by my wiles, this girl, I falsely wanted he would wed, shall lead him. Step by step towards the gallows, tread.
Trust him now on both sides.
find that villain, and I will punish him.
Yay!
Don't ye be foolish. Injure William Cawdor, you'll only harm yourself. I'll come now, we'll see your parents stowed in comfort. And then I'll be off to work. There's little I can do to make a man like Cawdor pay. The gentry have their laws, and we, the common folk, must obey.
Jimmy, lads, I'm so
and await my coming.
the red barn. It's so lonely there, it frightens me.
Be brave, Mariah. I will be there within a quarter of an hour. Just think what lies in store for us.
No!
I will. Oh, William.
I was so sad.
But now I'm so happy.
Yeah.
Do not be long, my beloved.
I don't live there anymore.
Do not be.
I'm sorry, she did.
Do not be long.
No.
Wretched child has sealed her own doom by following me here.
No!
I must dispose of her, or all will be lost.
No!
Fortunately, I have my pistol.
My leg!
But I must bury the body and that of the child. Hold that for a second. How? What needs to be done? Who comes here? What a lucky chance a yokel with the very tool I require. Hey!
The fine fellow.
You,
my good man, how would you care to earn
a guinea?
No thanks.
What?
Well, I was already wimping away today. I don't want to work anymore.
Fool!
What's that?
I mean,
how sensible.
But I don't mean to make you work for the guinea, no. I mean to give it to you.
Give it to me?
Give it to you.
Give it to me.
Give it to you.
Give it to me.
Give it to you.
Give it to me.
Give it to you.
A guinea?
Yes.
Well, dangly points and he calls I a fool.
But I want something for it. The loan of your spade for an hour.
Me spade?
Your spade.
Me spade.
Your spade.
Me spade.
Your spade.
Me spade.
Your spade.
Yeah. Oh, I'm sorry.
Derek.
Ah!
Wait, there's something else. Oh!
And what do you need me spade for? Are you going to bury something?
Well, to be frank, yes, I'm going to bury a mad dog. That I shot this morning.
Liar.
Shot this morning.
It was by the red barn.
Yes.
Where I shall bury the dog.
Boo.
Let's see like it.
Even bother! What be the matter, Miss Marten?
Oh, Jerry! You know my terrible dream I told you of? I've had it 7 times this month. I saw Maria standing here with a baby in her arms. And it is very sad, Jemmy. And on my dress there was this great red spreading stain. Oh, Jemmy, I am sure the harm has come to her.
So am I. My fears. I've been to London.
So you went on an holiday? When you think my daughter is missing, you go on an holiday to London?
Quite like that. I secured the services of this gentleman!
Very well. I have to say I'm underwhelmed.
Well, of this gentleman!
Not to fly!
nothing to harm it. Get to your fine house like mine, Bill, and enjoy it as you can!
Oh, get that! Get that sound! Oh, yeah. Oh, let him go! Oh, you get it! Oh, keep running! Bring him here! Give him my hand, someone will!
Talking yeah. So much, Jenny! Mrs. Martin, do you recognise this door?
Yes, yeah, Mrs. Martin!
Martin,
do you recognise this
story? Oh, I do, it hurts. It was Maria's. Where did you find it?
No, it was lying in her grave where he did bury her. That's not true. You can't prove anything, no matter what you find.
You deny, you murderer.
Yes, and so why don't you just lie buried in the old red barn?
Oh, you have uttered your own condemnation, William Corridor. Nobody said. Well, Maria was found, and no one said it was at the Red Barn.
Stand
and what of this?
It's not mine.
No, yes, it has your name upon it.
Confess and beg for mercy, Toro. Your hour has come.
The law will take its course, there will be no mercy.
Have you anything else to say, William Corder?
Just this.
Oh, here we go.
Hello.
I hope you see my hands to play.
Forgive my misdeeds, all of you. My life is near an end. I loved Maria deep and true. But I must make amends, for my life was led astray by gold and all the world holds good. For I threw away true love, that I shed my blood.
So they hang William Corder.
So For the final closing speech, we have a special guest.
I've lost my special guest.
It's a special guest. Laura, I made up on the spot. Laura!
Laura!
Are you looking for me?
Yes, you're giving the final speech, darling.
Come on, Laura.
Just one moment. You just can't get the cash nowadays. That's the problem.
Come on now.
My special guest, Laura! Speech, I believe.
Oh!
Yes, you are.
Oh, I didn't know that. I'm not going to say it. No, I suppose I could drop this now. And say thank you to everybody for coming along this evening.
Yay!
All of these guys here have been over at Porter's Row throughout the day. They've been called, or they've carried on. They've been entertaining people all day long, and then to do it this evening as well, and give as good as they've got. I'm so, so proud of them. They give all they've got every single time, so can you give it up for them? Thank you to T, wherever she is, for doing the sound tonight. Our crazy shenanigans.